1068. Good afternoon from Hempstead, New York.
And Obi is called for the foul on the back of Gilbert Brown. First foul on Obi. Team second. Bazookas comes back. Walker to take a seat.
See, Gary McGee, big, strong kid. He will have a much bigger role for Pittsburgh next year. 6'10", 250, just a sophomore. Good upper body strength, and he really understands his role to set a lot of screens and roll to the basket.
Wanamaker also on the floor for Pitt.
There comes the big fellow way out on the floor to set a screen.
Fields looking for the screen, instead just pulls up, doesn't go, knocked out of bounds. We'll go to DePaul.
Pitt does not have a lot of flow right now to their offense. You see LaVance Fields barking out, there, set my screen there, make a move here. They really don't look like they're at top sync right now.
Is DePaul doing anything defensively that's confused them on the floor?
They're just playing hard. DePaul is giving a good effort right now. They've really come out ready to play. They know they're playing one of the best teams in America.
Koshwal against Big spins, lays it off to Obi, who throws it down.
See, the crowd's into it. This is what Pitt did not want. We talked about it in Keys to the Game. Quick start for Pitt, take the crowd out of it. DePaul's starting to play with a little passion now. The bench is into it.
Offensive foul on Pitt. Second team foul for the Panthers. DePaul off to a nice start. Koshwal finding Obi.
People who have been diagnosed with mesothelioma have many questions. How did I get this disease? What are my treatment options? How will this affect my loved ones? You need answers, which is why we offer a free book written by medical professionals who have treated mesothelioma.
Call toll-free 1-888-USA-MESO or go to freemesobook.com.
There's no obligation, so call 1-888-USA-MESO or go to freemesobook.com.
Catch the Johnnies live at the Garden for a Big East showdown as former Knicks coach Rick Pitino brings his nationally ranked Louisville Cardinals to town. St. John's basketball is back tomorrow on MSG. In the locker room.
That's all passes, we want that.
In the huddle.
Yeah, baby.
On the court.
Get inside
the game like never before.
When guys are playing together, you'll be surprised how well we can play. And we're playing good tonight.
Let's go, guys.
Knicks, Blazers, Sunday on MSG.
DePaul shooting 60% from the floor. They lead by three. 11:38 left to play in the first half. Take me inside to play, Cappy.
Well, weak side help. Someone has, look at the low block right here. Postage is caught on the high side. First of all, you got to play low side when the ball's below the free throw line, and either Koshwal or Kelly have to rotate down and play the backside of DeJuan Blair so that pass can't come in so easy. Once the pass went over the top of the defender, what did he have to do? Just lay it in.
But offensively for the Blue Demons, as I said, they've knocked down 6 of 10 shots, and Pitt's coming off a victory, a 20-point win the other night against Robert Morris, a non-conference game, in which they allowed Robert Morris to shoot over 57% from the field, 59% from three-point range. Robert Morris, just a third team this season to score over 70 points against Pitt in a game. Could the lack of defense in that game be carrying over to this game against the Blue Demons?
Well, when you play in a league like this where it's Connecticut, and then you play Marquette, and then you play Notre Dame, and then you've got Louisville, there are times that their players are human, that they're not going to be as razor sharp as you would hope. Koshwal knocks down a baseline jumper there, as razor sharp every single night. When they look on the schedule, they see Robert Morris, they believe they're going to win the game just by coming to the arena, and they look at DePaul and say they're 0-10, and so they're not as sharp as they need to be.
Koshwal lost it going up. Walker, right place, right time, misses the follow. Wow, blown opportunity for DePaul there. Could have gone up seven. Timeout called by Jamie Dixon. He is not happy with his guys.
No, he's not getting the effort he wants to see from his guys right now. They're flat. You take a look at the turnover, that's just reading the passing lane, coming up and taking it all the way, but Koshwal has got to finish this. I mean, he's 6'10". You have got to make sure that cannot be missed.
There's Jamie Dixon giving his guys an ear fill right now after their four turnover. Today's Big East Coaches Spotlight brought to you by Oppenheimer Funds, the right way to invest. And let's take a closer look here at head coach Jamie Dixon of Pitt. Did you know he was still carrying his Screen Actors Guild card?
Yes, and there's a famous commercial that ran for a long time way back in his career. It was a commercial for Bud Light, and a young lady dunks on him, and he still gets people saying, "You're the guy in the commercial that the young lady dunked on."
And he doesn't like that.
I'm sure not, because he was a great player, drafted by Washington in the NBA.
Yeah, played for TCU as Blair uses the glass to come up with two.
DePaul is going to have to double that on the post. Otherwise, DeJuan Blair is going to have a career day. When I say double, they're going to have to take a guard and run him down every time Blair gets the ball on the low post in the scoring area.
He's coming off a career effort against Luke Herangode in Notre Dame, a game in which he had 23 points and 22 rebounds. Another rebound for Blair right there. Ball goes out of bounds. Ashton Gibbs on the floor for Pitt. Fields getting ready to come back along with Dixon. Gibbs takes a seat.
Fields is such a great security blanket for a head coach to have. You know when he's on the court that every single person is going to be told where they need to be, what has to happen. He's a great leader.
Young actually lost it and then caught it on his back. His call for the travel and a follow-up on your comment about LaVance Fields. Ranked second in the country in assist-to-turnover ratio. He just doesn't give it up. 155 assists, only 42 turnovers coming into today.
And that's against some of the best pressure defense that you will ever face.
Tucker on the floor, to the bucket, draws the foul.
Nice job on the dribble drive action, getting himself to the backboard, and nobody really stepped up and took that path to the glass away. Here comes the dribble drive. He turns the corner on the defender, and really DeJuan Blair never slid over there and said, no, you're not getting to the rim, and the foul was created.
Foul was on Wanamaker, team third foul for Pitt. Here comes Faber back, Obi to take a seat. See, Obi with some key minutes.
What I would love to see DePaul do is you're going to have Koshwal on the floor almost 40 minutes. Dar Tucker, same deal, as long as his ankle is healthy. But take the other two big guys, and even with Devin Hill, and use them in spurts and just say, okay, you played three solid minutes, I'm going to take you out, get another guy who's fresh. And you have these big bodies and see if you can try and get something going with them.
5-point lead, 5 points for Tucker now.
Jerry Wainwright is one of the better defensive minds in college basketball. He has looked at everything, but it's just such a great league.
Count it! And he'll go to the line. DeJuan Blair, who got around his defender, Faber, now, and then threw up the reverse layup that went.
He is just making a living on the low post. He is going to screen. Now he's going to flash across and watch the pass come in, and there is nobody there to stop him. He has got to be the focal point of what DePaul does defensively, because he is an absolute man on the low post.
He's a monster down there, 6'7", 265. Obi comes back. Blair, 4 of 5 underneath, 9 points, 3 rebounds already. Go, 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 go. Walker. Dixon defending. Carjois. Boy, just slid right through the Pitt defense.
Pitt's flat-footed defensively right now. They are not playing with the spark that they normally do defensively, and another turnover.
Walker comes up with a steal all the way to the other end.
Crowd's into it. They're percolating here at the Allstate Arena.
5 points for Walker and a 6-point lead for the home team. Blair wants it. He gets it. Poked away by Walker.
But you see, they double the post that time. Have to do it.
Young takes the three and knocks it down.
Big basket.
Sam Young averages 18 a game. He has seven.
Big basket. Ice water on the crowd.
Tucker pulls the trigger on the three. Doesn't go. And Young pulls down the miss. Wanamaker down the baseline. Throws up the floater and it falls.
Tough shot. Turn the corner, dart. Tucker really did not do a very good job at forcing him to the baseline. Gave him the angle to shoot the shot, and that rainmaker went down.
He's been terrific off the bench in the last three games, averaging 10 points, 10 of 16 from the floor. Big two there for Wanamaker. Tucker at the other end. That three doesn't go. Obi had it and lost it.
Great steal.
Poked away by Tucker. And Tucker goes the other way. Tried to draw the foul from Young, didn't get it, but got the two.
Dar Tucker very close to getting a technical foul. He thought he was bumped from behind. May have been, but you do not talk to the official, and he let him know. Stop.
Dixon's shot didn't go. Tucker knocks it out of bounds. It will go to Pitt after a timeout. So DePaul, led by as many as six, Pitt got back in the basketball game. But Dar Tucker wasn't about to let the Panthers take over. Laid it up for two, a 3-point lead.
The Suzuki SX4 Sport has a unique pop-up Navi system, a roomy cabin, 30 miles per gallon highway, and more horsepower than the Honda Civic LX, all for under $16,000. So we can pretty much assure you'll have a great time in it. Once you're out of it, you're on your own. The Suzuki SX4. Live large, drive small. Suzuki. Now get 0% financing on all 2008 Suzuki Sport and Sedan models. Hurry in.
Have you seen how good the Big East is this year? But hey, based on its tradition, are you surprised? The numbers don't lie. Start with 16 prestigious universities, 15 of whom have played in the Final Four. 5 have won national championships. 8 are among the winningest programs of all time. Throw in 4 Hall of Fame coaches, dozens of All-American players, and I don't even have time to tell you about all the classic games. It's called tradition, baby, and a new...
Hey, Pixels! We're free!
Yeah!
Hold it! Hold it! We're not free. We're free.
I'm confused.
We're IOTV, and we offer 60 HD channels free. HD is free with IOTV.
Oh. Shark Week!
Incredible HD picture, awesome HD sound. IOTV brings you the best HD experience free.
Garaco Suits is the brand that's been saving people money for over 25 years. This week, we're offering a special deal on the Garaco 3-suit package. What is the Garaco 3-suit package? Buy 3 suits for $299.99 and get 15 items free. That is 3 shirts, 3 ties, 3 belts, 3 pairs of socks, and 3 hankies, absolutely free. Mention this TV ad and receive an additional $50 off. That is 18 items for just $249.99. Don't miss this limited time offer. Come experience the Garaco difference today.
It's Wednesday when the Devils battle the Islanders on MSG Plus.
Welcome back to Rosemont, Illinois. Allstate Arena, fifth-ranked Pitt taking on DePaul. I'm Lou Cadellis, Dave Kaplan alongside. Blue Demons with a nice start, and they lead 24-21 over the Panthers, and turnover has been a bugaboo for Pitt so far.
Great effort defensively out of DePaul. Thought they did a real nice job at getting up in passing lanes, tracking down errant passes. Here you'll see a strip of Sam Young on the low block. There's a travel when he couldn't put the ball on the deck. Here's another one off of Young. They pick his pocket, and Dar Tucker gets the bucket at the other end. Real good effort out of DePaul so far. Jamie Dixon is working hard on the sidelines, trying to get his guys refocused. Jerry Wainwright, very, very happy with what he's seen so far. They just got to make sure they continue to do a better job executing their half-court attack offensively.
In each of Jerry Wainwright's three full seasons here at DePaul, the Blue Demons have defeated at least one top 25 opponent. Blair's shot didn't go there for his miss. Again he goes. Wow, three cracks at it.
Well, no double again on the low block. It's the Dunkirk. You can't do it. You cannot stop that guy without doubling the block. Otherwise, it's a career night for him.
At the other side, Tucker's three doesn't go. We've seen Tucker settle for three so far here in the first half. Fields. Back to Blair. Blair too hard off the glass. Devin Hill into the game, pulls down the miss.
Blair's a little winded. He's getting a ton of activity in there.
Walker's three didn't go. Hill another rebound. Tucker against Dixon. On the floor, looking for room, throws it up after he drew the foul. Shot didn't go, but Tucker will go to the free throw line.
Good head and shoulder fake by Dar Tucker, which created the contact and gets him an opportunity.
You've had the chance to see Tucker the last couple of seasons. Jerry Wainwright says he's 500% better than he was a year ago. Where has he improved his game?
He is a much better player at not taking as many bad shots as he did a year ago, and he's a phenomenal talent. He has ability to play at the next level, but at times he gets frustrated when it isn't dropping for him, and he continues to sometimes press and take shots that as a coach you go, boy, I wish you would just make the extra pass. You're going to get it back. You're our best perimeter player. And he's starting to understand that.
Tucker with eight. 2-point lead for DePaul. Gibbs down low. Blair, double team. Finds someone down low. It was Brown. Shot didn't go. Knocked out of bounds. We'll go to DePaul.
But again, there was a double team on the low block, which meant Blair had to give it up. Now, the problem was he was able to make too easy a bounce pass across the lane, which should have led to a basket, Pitt would tell you. DePaul did a real good job to finally force the ball out of bounds, and it goes the Blue Demons' way.
Bazookas on the floor along with Jeremiah Kelly, Devin Hill, Dar Tucker, and Matt Cajwal. Cajwal gets it against Blair with the right hand, got the roll.
He caught it where he wanted it, able to go over his right shoulder, flip it up and get it to go. Soft touch.
Last night, the upset in the league. South Florida beat Marquette 57-56. Villanova's knocked off number 20 Syracuse, 102-85. At the other end, Dark Hucker leads it, lays it up and in.
Another timeout, Jamie Dixon. He's furious. Great effort by DePaul. Wonderful outlet pass. Good hustle by Dar Tucker. Wasn't great recovery and recognition from offense to defense by the Pitt Panthers.
Cincinnati also defeated Georgetown 64-62 in overtime. The last play we just saw.
There's a miss on a long pass. Bazookas grabs the long carom. Look right down the court, and Sam Young doesn't realize Dar Tucker sprinting down the court. Beats him, catch, score.
Tucker and Cajwal each with 10 points so far. And DePaul, the 6-point advantage. Blue Demons trying to snap a 10-game losing skid. DePaul hasn't lost 11 in a row since the 96-97 season when they dropped 13 straight. Jerry Wainwright just begging the fans in Chicago, relax, be patient with us. It's a young ball club. Our two best players are sophomores. We've got a freshman on the floor, and Michael Bazookas, Jeremiah Kelly. But in the Big East gives you no time to grow.
What a league.
Four of the last five games for DePaul against top 10 teams. How tough is that for a young squad?
Unbelievable.
Shot doesn't go. Knocked around, and Hill comes out with it. Yeah,
Dar Tucker all alone for three. Goes out of bounds. We'll stay at this end with the Blue Demons.
Went off of DeJuan Blair. Open look for Dar Tucker, but I thought he hesitated for a second. He's a rhythm shooter. He catches it in the corner. He looked and went, oh, I'm wide open. Now let's shoot it. He has got to look at it. Go, if that ball comes my way, my hands are set, my shoulders are over my toes, I'm locked and loaded, ready to go.
Wanamaker back on the floor for Pitt. Tucker, by the way, just one of six from three-point range. Boy, he had Hill wide open underneath. Tucker back at his way in. Too hard off the glass.
They did. They missed Devin Hill on the screen and then pop right to the basket.
Gibbs all alone, could have read a book, no one within 10 feet of him.
Well, he used his dribble to reset himself. Recycle, got ready to go, and he nailed it. Koshwal wants it.
He gets it against Blair. Fronts Blair, going to the bucket and carried it. 29-26, DePaul leads fifth-ranked Pitt. Panthers trying to improve to 21-2.
This Valentine's Day, give the sweetest of American traditions, Whitman's chocolate. The Whitman's Sampler Heart, an American favorite since 1842.
You're in the market, but what do you want your numbers to add up to? Maybe a time-tested way to help reach your financial goals. At Oppenheimer Funds, we follow proven principles, like investing for the long term, so you can ride out the market's ups and downs, and perhaps end up with the second career you've always wanted.
Call your advisor for a prospectus with complete fund information. Read it carefully and carefully consider fund investment objectives, risk, charges, and expenses before investing.
Oppenheimer Funds, the right way to invest.
You can't have Valentine's Day without chocolate.
Chocolate makes you feel good.
It's a real girl thing.
Women love chocolate.
They just go together.
I'm in heaven.
Don't give her just any chocolates. Give her Russell Stover chocolates with the famous Russell Stover bow.
That's the money you could be saving with Geico.
What?
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
It's the money you could be saving with Geico. You were made for each other. You like money. He likes money. Well, he is money.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Sunday, February 15th, MSG celebrates Black History Month with a groundbreaking lineup of originals and specials honoring the legends who have forever changed the face of sports. The great Jackie Robinson.
He was always a guy to stand up for his rights.
Super Bowl winning coach Tony Dungy. The Kings of the Ring, from Joe Louis to Muhammad Ali. And the man who broke the NBA color barrier, the Knicks' Sweetwater Clifton.
I really was the first one.
Celebrate Black History Month, Sunday, February 15th, starting at 6, only on MSG.
Strong defensive effort from DePaul. Matt Koshwal, he's got 10 in this game already. Blue Demons lead 29-26. Today's Big East game is being produced and distributed by ESPN Regional Television, Inc.
Now, when you double-team the post, from a DePaul perspective, you never quit on the play. Watch the pass going to come in to DeJuan Blair. Okay, number 30, Will Walker. He's going to go down and show a double-team. He goes right there, but he quits on the play. You can, now the rule is you can't leave the double till you've either forced him to pick up his dribble or watched him pass it back out, and then you help him recover. And then it's just tremendous effort by DeJuan Blair to outwork four DePaul Blue Demons.
One thing we've seen in the first 16 minutes of this game is you give Blair an opportunity to down low to work his way around and follow his shot, and he'll end up killing you as LaVance Fields knocks down the three to tie us up at 29.
You know, as poorly as Pitt has played, and the Pitt fans watching at Pittsburgh are going to say, boy, our team doesn't look very good. They're tied.
Walker all the way to the bucket off the glass.
Nice dribble drive. He turned a corner on Fields. Nobody came over and cut the baseline off.
In that last game against Marquette, Walker had 5 threes, a career high 30 points. Shot comes up short for Gibbs.
Koshwal wants it again. He's asking for it. It's a great matchup. Koshwal and DeJuan Blair.
Walker against Wanamaker. Bazukas, shot clock under 10. Walker looking for room. Bazukas, shot clock down to 4. Throws it up off the glass. Michael Bazukas.
Another real nice dribble drive, and nobody stepped up and really challenged him. Tough shot high off the window.
First two in the game for the freshman. DePaul back to the 4-point advantage, and Young is fouled by Hill up in the air.
Watch Michael Bazukas. Put the ball on the deck. He turns the corner on LaVance Fields, and Young a day late and a dollar short to rotate over, and Bazukas with a tough runner.
Sam Young to the free throw line. 7 points, 5 rebounds so far for the senior. Knocks down the first, 71% from the line this season for Young. Gibbs takes a seat. Dixon comes back.
And you get Keeney Obi back, getting a lot of playing time here in the first half.
Hill goes to the bench. Young misses a second, but there's Blair to clean up.
Again, that unbelievable effort that he gives you on the backboard.
5 offensive rebounds for Blair. He averages 6 a game. Bazooka's dogged by Fields. Down low, Obi, right around Blair. Didn't get the roll.
Tough shot. Blair makes it so difficult. He uses that body to hold you off.
Obi pokes it away.
Real nice job by Obi to get a hand in there without fouling and prevent the pass from coming into a wide open Blair.
Nice job by Blair to save it, and then Dixon comes up with a three. Jermaine Dixon, 29% from 3-point range.
We're going to talk about why his shooting has gotten better in just a moment. It's an amazing story of what he did.
Pitt's in front for the first time in a while. Young pokes it away. Shot comes up short. Fields there to finish. 3 Panthers were there all alone.
DePaul needs a timeout, and they're going to take one.
Pitt with a 4-point advantage. Fields already with 6 assists. What's happened to the Blue Demons?
You could start to sense a little run coming from Pitt. They looked like they had a little bit more of a bounce in their step. They're a little bit lazy of a pass, and Young off to the races. You could see Bazukas very upset, punched the basket support, said, guys, gotta take care of the basketball. But the man in there who just hit a shot, number 3, Jermaine Dixon, struggling after a 1-of-7 shooting performance, 0-for-5 from beyond the arc. His brother Juan Dixon, a former Maryland star playing for the Washington Wizards, was at the game. They're walking off the court. He says, you back on the floor. And he put his brother through a workout. His brother says, the hardest workout I've ever gone through. And he was barking at him. What are you doing with your shot? Let's change your motion. What are you doing with your elbow? And he had him sweating and working, and people are watching this. Well, since that point, he's shooting over 40% from beyond the arc. I think Juan's got a future as a coach.
Older brother knows best. Not a bad tutor. Koshwal double team, gives it up.
Real nice double by Pitt. They have kicked up their defensive intensity.
Oh, a nice shovel pass from Fields. Young gets it to go. 10 points for Sam Young.
And all of a sudden, it's danger time for DePaul. As well as they've played in spurts, 6 down.
Walker on the floor, up with the right hand. The finger roll didn't go, but he's called for the offensive foul, and Young took the charge.
Now look at the Pitt bench. The Pitt bench is up. They are into it. They just sat down. They were up cheering. They've got a little bit of a smile there, a couple of the guys. If you check that shot 10 minutes ago, they were all sitting there looking much more sullen. They weren't getting off the bench. There wasn't a bounce in the Panthers' step on the court. And things have changed in the last couple minutes because their defensive intensity has been better.
Fields and Pitt will play for the last shot here in the first half. 6-point lead for the Panthers. 20-2 on the season, 7-2 in league play. Fields finds Dixon alone for three.
Book it, there's another one for him.
What a finish for Pitt here in the first half. They trail by as many as six, and then a complete reversal. DeJuan Blair, 13 points, 6 rebounds, 5 offensive rebounds. Pitt down by 6, ends the first half up by 9, 42-33. Our halftime report rolls your way next.
College basketball fans, welcome to Hartford, home of the 2009 Big East Women's Basketball Championship, March 6th through 10th at the XL Center. Catch all 16 Big East teams live with packages just $99 for all sessions. Tickets are on sale now, so call 860-525-4500 or log on to Ticketmaster.com.
It's Vietnam and American history, the complete visual record of the war on DVD. You'll finally get the whole picture, from Tonkin Gulf to the fall of Saigon. Filmed in the heat of combat and behind enemy lines, Operation Rolling Thunder, the siege of Khe Sanh, the Tet Offensive. This is Vietnam without the bias, without the spin, digitally remastered on crystal clear DVD. Get Vietnam and American history on 3 DVDs for just $59.99. But wait, call with your credit card and you'll pay only $39.99. And if you call in the next 10 minutes, you'll get free shipping and handling. This is no Hollywood movie. This is the real thing. Newsweek hailed it as riveting and powerful. The New York Times said it may change opinions about the war. Call now to get Vietnam, American history on 3 DVDs for just $39.99 with free shipping and handling.
Call 1-800-832-5815 to order Vietnam and American history and receive free shipping when you use your credit card. Call now.
Is the high cost of credit card debt weighing you down? Let the Relyon Group get you back on your feet with just one free call. The Relyon Group can work out an affordable plan that works for you. Lower your monthly payments. Legally reduce your debt. Stop calls from creditors. Relieve your stress and start smiling again. If you're struggling with $15,000 or more in credit card debt, call now for a free no-obligation analysis. You don't have to live under a mountain of debt.
Call 800-232-6517.
Every day, over 500,000 New Yorkers are at risk of going hungry. Yet every night, local restaurants and markets are left with tons of extra food. City Harvest works round the clock to rescue this food and deliver it to New York's hungry. New York feeds all of us in its own way. Now it's time for us to help City Harvest feed the hungry of New York. Support City Harvest. To make a donation, call 1-800-77-HARVEST.
We've hit the break here in Chicago. Big East basketball between Pitt and DePaul. Luke and Ellis with you. It's the beginning of February as well, which means we are halfway through the season. What are your favorite plays so far? Do you have one? Well, guess what? We do. And here are our choices for plays of the year up to this point.
Everyone into a crowd, so raise your hands up and shout it out.
goes. And there it goes. School record. For the win.
He got it. He got it.
He's got it.
He got it.
And we still have another half of the season to add to that highlight reel. Plus, we have another half of basketball here in Rosemont, Illinois. But first, we'll take a look at the Big East Wire right after these messages.
Nobody gives you more power than Interstate Batteries. We have a national warranty program with over 200,000 dealers to back it up. How do we make them so powerful? Now that's a secret. Get the battery with more power in it and the most power behind it. Interstate Batteries, outrageously dependable.
I didn't want anyone to know that I was secretly having someone else find someone for me. When you own your own business, there's no time to go out, so I went on eHarmony to let them find Mr. Right for me.
Review your matches for free. eHarmony.com.
Gerdev, Callahan, he scores! That's a great play!
Woo! He did a good job of that.
Go, Chelsea, go, go! Oh, Lundquist made a great save! Scores!
The Rangers and Capitals, Wednesday on MSG.
Okay, Pixels, IOTV offers an incredible HD picture, and that means 110% from all of us. Blue, what do you need to do?
Be bluer.
Green?
Be greener.
That's right, because IOTV has one amazingly sharp HD picture.
Red!
Yes, pink.
Why do I have to be pink? Pink makes me look chubby.
Oh.
Rainbow!
Incredible HD picture and sound. IOTV brings you an extraordinary HD experience free.
For local news?
News 12 Long Island, nowhere else.
It's, you know, the important stuff. The city isn't local, it's the city.
News 12 Long Island.
It keeps me connected.
I rely on their traffic report every day. Who has time to sit in traffic?
Local weather. What's more important than that?
You can get it at home, on the web, on demand.
Even on the go. It's everything I need, all in one place.
What else could you ask for?
News 12 Long Island. Only on Cablevision, not on phone company TV or anywhere else.
Halftime in our game between Pitt and DePaul at the Allstate Arena. Blue Demons trying to copy South Florida's accomplishments of last night. Welcome back, Luke and Ellis, alongside David Kaplan. And South Florida upsets Marquette last night in Tampa, 57-56.
That really didn't surprise me. I saw South Florida when they came in here and pounded DePaul and looked at this team and said, anybody that doesn't have a great front line, they have frontline players that could step out and make jump shots, which means that a team with not great depth inside has to step out on the floor to defend those. It really will limit their rebounding. Marquette's not a great front court team, phenomenal perimeter club, and it played right into the hands on the road, and South Florida gets the big win.
One of those great players on the perimeter for Buzz Williams and the Marquette Golden Eagles, Jerome McNeil, the player of the week in the Big East.
Well, this is just a phenomenal player. 26 and a half points, 6.5 assists, 5 rebounds, 3 steals, 2.5 blocks in 2 wins. He can score. He's one of the best on-ball defenders in all of college basketball. You watch him finish in transition. He's tremendous, and he's unselfish when he knows somebody else has a better shot opportunity. He'll give the ball up. Most great scorers don't do that. This guy's the complete package. He's a pro.
McNeil led all scorers last night with 22 in the game, and he's gone for 20-plus in 7 straight games. Now let's talk about the rookie of the week in the Big East, Mike Rosario at Rutgers.
Well, this is a guy who could step out and knock down triples. He is very good. Reminds me offensively a lot of McNeil because he'll make the extra pass. He could score in transition, hit the jump shot, and he's got great athleticism. He is a big-time player and helping to turn around Rutgers basketball.
Rutgers will play host to Seton Hall tomorrow in Big East play. We've got another half to go here in Rosemont between Pitt and DePaul. We'll look at the first half highlights and run down the first half numbers right after this.
The Suzuki Grand Vitara is compact size like the Honda CR-V, but the Grand Vitara has an available V6 engine with more horsepower, a better warranty, and offers true four-wheel drive for superior off-road performance. And the Suzuki starts at thousands less than the Honda. So you can go where you want to go and still afford to do what you want to do. The Suzuki Grand Vitara. Live large, drive small. Suzuki. Now get 0% financing on all 2008 Suzuki Grand Vitara models. Hurry in.
Computer, but have bad credit? Blue Hippo to the rescue. Call now to get the computer you need regardless of your credit. Plus, two free gifts with order. Call now.
What's up, everyone? Pete here, and welcome to Blue Hippo, where anyone can get a brand new, brand name computer regardless of their credit. Take a look at this. You can send emails, download music and video, even organize your finances. This is a fully loaded desktop computer. So whether you want a desktop or you prefer the convenience of a laptop, you can get either one regardless of your credit. And if you order now, we'll send you a free color printer and a free flat screen TV so you can watch your favorite shows and movies and print and email digital photos. So to be clear, when you order today, you can get your choice of a brand new desktop or laptop with tons of great software, plus a free color printer and a free LCD TV. And remember, there is no credit check, and your approval is guaranteed. But you must call Blue Hippo now.
Devils hockey is on MSG. Catch the Devs Saturday at The Rock when Patrick Eliash and the rest of New Jersey look to keep it rolling when they take on Anze Kopitar and the LA Kings. The Devils and Kings, tonight on MSG.
Hi, everybody. I'm Mike Quick. Sunday at 11, it's the high school basketball game of the week. It's a rematch. A year ago, Mount Vernon went to Linden and lost. This time, the Knights invite them to Westchester County. Payback is on their mind Sunday morning at 11 on MSG+.
Fifth-ranked Pitt leads DePaul 42-33. Luke Kanellis, Dave Kaplan alongside. Let's look at our Star Watch guys from the beginning of the game. Loy Levant, LaVance Fields, and also Matt Koshwal.
Well, LaVance Fields shows you exactly what he knows his team needs. Make the extra pass. He finds his man on the wing, gets him a clean look, and then a great pass inside. Matt Koshwal had a very good first half, a real good start. Tough shot there over DeJuan Blair. Banged the glass hard. Did a good job here on the move, showing the ability to put the ball on the deck. So you look at some of the statistical breakdowns for these two guys. Koshwal giving you what you need. 10 points. Dar Tucker, 10 points. Walker hit a couple of bombs. But DeJuan Blair is an absolute horse today inside.
He had 13 points, 6 rebounds, 5 offensive boards. Sam Young also had 10. 42-33, second half rolls your way next.
Undergraduates, to scholars awarded the highest honors, home to talented and fearless athletes, to students who reach out to their communities. The University of Pittsburgh, leader in education, Pioneer in research, partner in regional development.
All right, sports fans, it's time to find Geico's number one fan. Tonight's winner will receive Geico t-shirts, hats, and an upgrade to courtside seats, and could star in a real Geico commercial. Let's see who it's gonna be. It looks like we have a winner. Yes, we do, folks. How about that? Congratulations. And remember, saving money at Geico.com. So easy, a caveman can do it.
If you owe over $15,000 in taxes, listen to this.
We owe the IRS $24,000, but we only pay $2,000.
We owe the IRS $30,000, but we only paid $1,700.
We owe the IRS $200,000, but we only paid $40,000.
If you owe over $15,000 to the IRS estate, call American Tax Relief now. We've helped thousands of people reduce their tax debt. Call now for a free, no-obligation consultation. We can stop levies and garnishments and get you the best possible settlement within IRS guidelines. If you qualify, we can settle your tax debt for just a fraction of what you owe.
We owed the IRS $3 million, but we paid less than $1 million.
Call 1-800-575-7791. That's 1-800-575-7791.
Ball 42-33. Let's take a look at our PNC first half highlights. David, and DeJuan Blair got things going for the Panthers.
Yes, he did. He was very tough inside. Good catch, good score off the backboard. Then a real nice move by Young down the lane. Nobody rotated over, and he finished. Matt Koshwal steps out, knocks down the baseline shot. You'll see him put the ball on the deck effectively in the first half. And here's Dar Tucker knocking down the triple. So DePaul, all of a sudden, a 33-29 lead turns into a 42-33 deficit.
What happened? Why? Why the 13-point reverse?
Because Pitt kicked up their defensive intensity and they stopped turning the ball over. They took better care of the basketball.
DePaul opens up the second half with the ball.
Keeney Obi starting in place of Matija Posic. Give him more size. He had a good first half.
Bazookas, Walker, Koshwal, Tucker, and Obi on the floor for DePaul. We'll stay at this end. 9 seconds left on the shot clock.
Good job rotating over by Jermaine Dixon. We saw in the first half, Bazookas get a runner. Will Walker get a runner where nobody stepped up. Here, he did a nice job to make DePaul put a bad shot up, and the ball got knocked away.
Tucker pulls up, comes up short. Obi there, back up with an follows his miss, goes up again, got caught underneath, but drew the foul.
Good start for DePaul, banging the glass. The big fella paying dividends already into that lineup. Well, here's Keeney Obi, doesn't put it on the deck. Good job. Go right back up now, recycle with his dribble and power up, and there's the foul.
I saw him in practice a couple of weeks ago and walked away shaking my head, saying, how does he play? And Jerry Wainwright said, don't worry, he plays better in the games than he does at practice. And sure enough, he's played well in the two times I've seen him against UConn, about 10 days ago and today.
Splits a pair of free throws. He needs to be in the weight room all offseason working on his leg and core strength so that he can power up and finish. At that size, he has a chance to be a very effective player.
He redshirted last year. Fields, the fadeaway, LaVance Fields, senior out of Brooklyn, New York, right off the playground that play.
Tough shot, fall away. He doesn't look to score much because he knows his role is to run the show. But when his team isn't playing their best, he's had open looks and he has made good use of his shot opportunities today.
Koshwal against Biggs, right to the bucket, barreled his way in. Obi cleans up again.
Big fella wasn't boxed out. There he used his upper body strength. You talked about his 300-plus bench press, and there he was able to get it up on the window.
6 points, make it 7 for Obi. That's a career high.
We'll look at Jerry Wainwright. Chicago guy, and you look at some of their youth and some of the height that he has been able to attract here. There are guys in the program that if they continue to develop physically, they could get the program turning.
Biggs with the right-handed hook. Gets the bounce. First two in the game for Tyrell Biggs.
Manufacture points off a baseline out-of-bounds play.
10-point game. Cogswell wanted it and drew the foul from Biggs. Second foul on Biggs. Second team foul for Pitt here in the second half.
Official and Biggs having a few words. Biggs going, what did I do? The official said, you bumped him with your arm. You can't do it. What they do is they call advantage, disadvantage. Who's got a disadvantage? And the disadvantage was put there with the pressure, but here Young comes up with the steal.
Young gets it to Blair, who is following the play. Back to Young. Young thought about it, now drives baseline and commits the offensive foul and can't believe it.
Nork and Jamie Dixon, good job by DePaul. Funnel toward the baseline and then cut that off. Here you'll see they funnel it toward the baseline. Boy, he had him on the side. He must have extended an arm that I couldn't see because he certainly wasn't set in front of him.
Second foul on Young, who considered foregoing his senior season to enter the NBA draft.
He made a good decision. He's had a great senior year. He's only become a better player with another year of great Big East competition.
18 points a game for Sam Young. Tucker trying to find room off the glass, didn't go. Knocked around on the floor, tied up. Young, Kelly, timeout. Jamie Dixon. 10-point lead. Pitt leads DePaul. Panthers trying to improve to 21-2 on the season.
They say a man should always dress for the job he wants. So why am I dressed up like a pirate in this restaurant? It's all because some hacker stole my identity. Now I'm in here every evening serving chowder and iced tea. Should have gone to freecreditreport.com. I could have seen this coming at me like an atom bomb. They monitor your credit and send you email alerts so you don't end up selling fish to tourists in t-shirts.
Offer applies with enrollment and Triple Advantage.
Nobody gives you more power than Interstate Batteries. And we have a national warranty program with over 200,000 dealers to back it up. How do we make them so powerful? Now that's a secret. Get the battery with more power in it and the most power behind it. Interstate Batteries, outrageously dependable.
Hi, I'm John Scherer, CEO and founder of Video Professor. I'm the guy that makes computer learning quick and easy with the CD-ROMs from Video Professor. I'm so confident that my product will work for you that I'll send you any one of my lessons absolutely free. If you're serious about learning to run your computer once and for all, what do you got to lose? Try my product.
To get your free computer learning CD, you must call now.
Call 1-800-249-7916. That's 1-800-249-7916.
Catch the Johnnies live at the Garden for a Big East showdown as former Knicks coach Rick Pitino brings his nationally ranked Louisville Cardinals to town. St. John's basketball is back tomorrow on MSG. In the locker room.
That's all passes. We want that.
In the huddle.
Hey. Yeah, baby.
On the court.
Match up,
get inside
up.
The game like never before.
When guys are playing together, you'll be surprised how well we can play. And we're playing good tonight.
Let's go, guys.
Knicks, Blazers, Sunday on MSG.
Is the deepest and most athletic team coach Jamie Dixon has fielded in his time at Pitt, including those Sweet 16 teams of 2004 and 2007, and more talent is on the way, isn't it?
Reinforcements are headed his way, led by Dante Taylor, who is a big-time player out of Christian Academy in Maryland, 6'9", 220. And then you've got Lamar Patterson, 6'5", 220, out of a great school at St. Benedict's Prep. And a couple of others, 6'9 and 6'8. So size is going to be there.
And speaking of St. Benedict will play another day coming up on ESPNU midnight tonight at 10 o'clock Eastern on ESPNU. De La Salle and Dominguez.
I love high school basketball. Huge fan.
The Old Spice High School Showcase Nike Extravaganza here on ESPNU later tonight. Blair hits the jumper over Obi.
Says, okay, you guys gonna double me on the block, you're gonna force me a little farther out, then I'll make that shot. He's just a sophomore.
14 double-doubles on the season coming into today. Fourth nationally in rebounding at 13 boards a contest. Six offensive rebounds a game, that's best in the country. What can't DeJuan Blair do?
Well, the question is, can he play 15, 16 feet away from the basket, because he's not going to be a center if he ever plays in the NBA. He's going to have to be able to show a bit at stepping out and making shots in an up-tempo transition game with a 24-second clock. I think he can make the transition. I think he's one heck of a player. Anybody that plays with that kind of effort, play for my team. Wow, does he play hard.
Other Big East scores from earlier today. 16th-ranked Villanova beat number 22 Syracuse by 17, 102-85. And Cincinnati won at Georgetown in overtime, 64-62. Rough going for the Hoyas. And UCLA beats up Notre Dame, 89-63. Seven losses in a row for the Irish.
They went from being preseason top seven or eight with a great win over Texas to possibly not even making the tournament. Shocking.
Updated Big East Conference standings. UConn atop the league at 10-1. Marquette, by virtue of its first loss last night to South Florida, 9-1. Louisville, 8-1. And there are the Pitt Panthers that we're watching right now at 7-2. Loose ball gets into the hands of Jeremiah Kelly. 4-1 break for DePaul.
And one.
You called it. Koshwa lays it up and in, and he'll go to the line for the three-point play. It will happen after a timeout on the fast break. Jeremiah Kelly finds Koshwa, who now has a dozen.
It looks like nothing else on the road right now, proclaims GQ magazine.
Did you see that?
The interior positively oozes class, raves Car magazine. Slick and sensuous, boasts the Washington Times. The most striking VW in recent memory, declares.
Okay, I get it already.
I think we were in a car commercial.
We've got a ton of stuff we've got to pay for.
And a few things we want to pay for.
On top of it all, we're still trying to put away some money for the future. With the wish list, we can save up for anything we want.
And still have enough to cover the day-to-day. Plus, the savings engine helps our money grow.
And that's something we need and want.
Introducing the virtual wallet from PNC. A high-definition online view of your money. PNC.
Customer service.
Yes, ma'am.
Let me call up your account. Says here you recently moved.
Network slow today. I apologize.
What you see here is the difference your network makes.
Well, where is that report?
Here it is. Got it.
Is our network down again?
The network on the right is Optimum LightPath.
So how about the new field office on schedule?
Well, we're having network issues.
Up and running.
Optimum serves businesses of every size. Larger companies rely on Optimum LightPath.
Do you have a phone? Listen to this. J.D. Power and Associates asked thousands of people across the region to rate their phone service. But they rated all the big names. And guess what happened? Optimum Voice is ranked highest in residential telephone customer satisfaction in the Eastern region by J.D. Power and Associates. Optimum Voice. Keep your phone. Lose your phone company.
Fifth-ranked Pitt leads DePaul by 10, 48-38 here in the second half. Welcome back to the All-State Arena. Luke Kanellis along with Dave Kaplan. It's been an easy, even second half so far.
It has. DePaul has played pretty well today when you consider their 0-10 going up against number 5 in the country. Pitt started slow, but they're starting to show why they are such a great team, especially the big fella, DeJuan Blair. He's a stud.
DeJuan Blair has been tough to stop so far, not only offensively, but he's been a monster on the boards as usual. 48-38. All season long, Champion Apparel will be showcasing the tradition and history of the Big East Conference. We'll talk about it coming up. 48-38. Plenty of alumni honored today here at DePaul. The basketball game, we'll talk about that coming up as well.
Yeah, a ton of guys came back. Kevin Edwards, just a phenomenal player for those Joey Meyer coach teams, among some of the stars that are here.
What a shovel pass from Fields to Blair, who finishes.
See, that's what Fields does. He breaks you down, he takes it to the paint, and the big fella is there. All he has to do is deliver it like a waiter. He just sets you up. Here's your gourmet dinner right there in front of the rim. Ticky-tack foul, definitely a foul. Just a touch foul, and the big fella powers through it.
Seven assists a game for Fields coming in, and he is having a field day today. 11 helpers already. 13-point lead for Pitt.
See how much more aggressive Pitt is defensively? I mean, they're up contesting shots. It's just different than they were the first 7, 8, 9 minutes of the game.
Fields, another shovel pass to Blair, who throws it down with one hand with authority. Wow, he's got 20.
Look out. I mean, Pitt's starting to roll. Timeout, Jerry Wainwright. He's got words for the official. Takes a 30-second timeout.
15-point lead for Pitt. And DeJuan Blair has just been a man amongst kids.
He is just such a dominant player. He steps out, knocks down that jumper. Here the double comes late. He rolls right to the rim and just keeps working. Look at the effort.
He's having a good time, isn't he?
He's having a lot of fun in the Windy City.
Two of the better sophomores in college basketball.
Blake Griffin is a great, great player. A little bit more athletic in the way that he plays. 19 double-doubles is just a tremendous number. But DeJuan Blair, as he continues to work hard on his perimeter shot, and I'm not talking about being a three-point threat, just stepping out to 16, 17 feet, forcing defenders to come out and play that aggressively, and then go to the block, and he's going to be unstoppable.
Shovel pass, Postich lays it up and in. Give the assist to Koshwa.
Good pass by Koshwa, good finish by Postich, but nice interior passing by the Blue Demons.
First two for Postich. Fields, the Wanamaker at an open three. Now he takes it and hits it.
But look at the pass. I would rather watch the pass again on the replay. The shot was great, but he was set, ready to shoot it. He just, boom, right across the court through the seam of the defense, and his shooter was ready.
He's equaled his career high now with 13 assists, LaVance Fields has. Koshwa lost it on the floor, loose. Koshwa able to call timeout.
Watch this pass. I mean, right through the seam. He's on the move. Boom! Before the defender, Dar Tucker, could turn his head, the pass is there, the shooter is set. You don't find point guards like that every day. That pass, that ability to put it on the deck, keep surveying the landscape, and then the pass is there.
56-40. Pitt in front all season long. Champion Apparel will be showcasing the tradition and history of the Big East Conference. Today, let's take a look at DePaul's Bobby Simmons, only player in Blue Demons history to record 1,000 points, 700 rebounds, 200 assists, and 100 three-point field goals. Currently, he ranks sixth in school history in three-pointers, 15th in rebounding, 20th in scoring, and Jerry Wainwright wishes he had Bobby Simmons on his squad right now.
Did you see who he laid that one back in over? Kirk Heinrich and Nick Collison of Kansas. That was a good DePaul team.
Going back in time as Tucker follows. He has a dozen in the game. Simmons playing in New Jersey right now. Some talk here in Chicago. Maybe Bobby Simmons coming back home.
Good player.
Played his high school ball at Simeon. Tucker comes up with a steal.
That's got to be, I was going to say, an intentional foul, but he did go for a block. Love to get another look at that. We'll see if he ever played the ball or not. There's the turnover. Just a lazy pass. Here he comes. And he's looking to try and block the shot. Good call.
Foul was on Gilbert Brown. So Tucker will go to the free throw line. 15 foul on Pitt, and Tucker with two shots.
That's why they get the whistle and I get to sit over here. First blush, I thought, got to be intentional. But good call.
Biggs back. Young to the bench. Tyrell Biggs rather quiet in this game. Tucker now with 14. Will Walker back into the game. And it's a 12-point lead for Pitt. DePaul hanging around, trying to snap a 10-game losing skid. Pitt, the fourth top 10 opponent in the last five for DePaul. Littiemans haven't lost 11 in a row in 12 years. Wanamaker had it knocked away out of bounds by Walker, so it will stay with Pitt. 18 still on the shot clock. Blair, boy, right around post, and she throws it up.
That one hit the clock, I think.
Thought it hit the roof, it went so high. Wanamaker knocks down the three.
Well, just a bad turn of events for DePaul, and another rebound for Pitt off a missed shot. They are among the best offensive rebounding teams I've seen in a long time.
Out-rebound their opponents by 9 a game. Controlling the boards in this one as well. Koshwal, shot goes in and out. One and done for DePaul. Fields got his defender in the air with the right hand off the glass. Wasn't that pretty?
That was pretty. Head and shoulder fake. Always surveying the scene, and then he gets the runner.
Walker at the other end gets two back.
See, DePaul can't keep trading baskets. They're 15 down to the number 5 team in the country. Got to get some stops.
Biggs for 3. Hit back iron, but followed his miss.
Another offensive rebound.
Brown puts it on the floor. Bounce pass Blair. Down low. Koshwal commits the foul. And Blair to the free throw line. 61-46. RPI strength of schedule in the Big East. Pitt, number 2 RPI. 9th strength of schedule. Followed by UConn, Louisville, Villanova, West Virginia. Look at that Georgetown. Their RPI is 23. They lose again today. They fall to 4-7. But with an RPI of 23, they're still getting into the tournament, aren't they?
As long as they don't go on a prolonged losing streak, I would agree. I think they're
their strength of schedule, 4th in the country.
Unbelievable.
And that is how tough this league is.
But they will be, if they don't get on a little bit of a roll here, they'll be one of those teams on Selection Sunday sweating if conference champions don't win their conference tournaments at some of the other leagues. And you go, oh, my goodness.
How about Notre Dame?
I don't know.
3-7 now in the
Big East.
What's
happening there?
They've lost 7 in a row after losing today against UCLA.
I'm a big fan of Mike Gray. Heron Godey's an outstanding player. They got a great shooter in McElarney, but they don't have much else going right now.
Dwan Blair takes a seat. 22 points, 10 rebounds, 15th double-double of the season. That's a full day's work for some guys. He's just taking a breather in this one. Koshwal draws the foul from Gary McGee. 6th team foul. Right now it's all Pitt. 63-46. Dwan Blair resting with 22 points and 10 rebounds.
Citizens. Puerto Rico, explore beyond the shore.
You're in the market, but what do you want your numbers to add up to? Maybe a time-tested way to help reach your financial goals. At Oppenheimer Funds, we follow proven principles, like investing for the long term, so you can ride out the market's ups and downs. and perhaps end up with the second career you've always wanted.
Call your advisor for prospectus with complete fund information. Read it carefully and carefully consider fund investment objectives, risk, charges, and expenses before investing.
Oppenheimer Funds, the right way to invest.
Introducing the Toby, the world's first and only professional powered upright and portable wrinkle removing machine. Designed to wipe out wrinkles up to 5 times faster than ironing. From the most delicate silk to the toughest denim and everything in between. It also helps to remove unpleasant odors so you can refresh your clothes at home and stop wasting money at the dry cleaners. Plus, remove wrinkles from curtains and drapes right on the rod and bed linens right on the bed. Call now and get your very own Toby for just $99 or just 3 easy payments of $33. And we'll send you 2 attachments absolutely free so you can refresh sofas, chairs, and pillows, and remove lint and stubborn pet hair. Call right now and get the Toby Quick Steamer free. Just pay shipping and processing.
Call 1-800-920-7207. That's 1-800-920-7207.
DePaul by 17, 63-46. Welcome back to Allstate. Luke Canellis, Dave Kaplan. Coast to coast we go in the East. ACC Big East, 8 teams ranked amongst the top 10 in the South. VMI's offense, 96 a game. That leads the NCAA. Here in the Midwest, number 11 Butler, the highest ranked mid-major out there. And out west, Gonzaga with 9 consecutive wins plays host to Memphis tonight.
They're outstanding, led by Mark Few, who's just got that program in such a positive state of mind year after year. But I got to tell you, that Butler team, that's a big surprise. Brad Stevens is a fabulous coach. They lose 4 starters from a year ago, and they're better this year with all these freshmen. That guy can coach.
What are your thoughts on Gonzaga scheduling a non-conference game against a team like Memphis at this point in the season as Tucker throws it up for 2?
They need to do some things because of the strength of their league to open eyes for seeding purposes at the on Selection Sunday. I think it's a great challenge for their guys.
And Memphis, the same, because they need big games like that coming out of Conference USA.
Right. They're not in the Big East, the Big Ten, the ACC. Those are the premier leagues.
15-point game. Gibbs looking for room. Wanamaker. Shot rolls, didn't go. McGee had it, lost it. Brown finds Wanamaker. Who knocks it down? No, that's Gibbs in 3-point range.
Gibbs ready to shoot it. Ball came right out. He had a wide open look because so many bodies were at the glass trying to grab the rebound.
Ashton Gibbs, who had 13 in the first half last Saturday against Notre Dame, now with 6 in today's game. Caswell's shot didn't go. Tried the cross-court pass. Went off of Brown's hands, out of bounds. Back to DePaul.
We have to do a little maintenance on the court here for a second. Some sweat right underneath the basket.
3-point shooting. Pitt 50%, 9 of 18. DePaul 2 for 11 a week ago in that Notre Dame game. I don't know if you saw it, Cappy, but the Irish came out firing. They had 11 threes in the first half.
Mike Bray is trying everything he knows how to do, changing the lineup, kicking up tempo, take more threes, get the ball to Heron. It's just not working right now.
Walker missed everything with this 3-point attempt.
Just not the shot you're looking for. And in the first half, DePaul was beating Pitt down the court. Now we're seeing it the other way. It's a 20-point game. That shot is not what Jerry Wainwright's looking for.
Wanamaker now with 10. Shot so tough to come by against this Pitt defense for the Blue Demons. Shot clock down to 7. Tucker with the ball in his hands, trying to make something happen with the right hand.
Tough shot. Wow.
Tucker with 18. He missed the game on Tuesday against Marquette with a bad wheel. He's come back strong today.
Degree of difficulty gets a 9. Wow.
And Jerry Wainwright's tried everything. 8 different starting lineups this season. Just can't find the right combination. Wanamaker for 3. Another 3 for Wanamaker. He's got 13 off the bench.
Well, he just loads it up. There's no wasted motion on his shot. Some guys, you see the elbow flying. He just catches it and releases it.
Devin Hill decides to take the 3. I don't know if that was a shot that Jerry Wainwright was looking for.
Nope, and he's going to go to the bench and get the big fella, Keeney Obi, back.
Hill shoots only 18% from three-point range. Biggs, nice bounce pass. McGee can't finish. Hill, this time to the bucket. That's the shot that Jerry Wainwright wants.
That's where he succeeds, is in transition. He is not a three-point threat, and right now with his physical makeup, very thin, not a guy that's going to bang down there with McGee or Dewan Blair or whoever he's going to be forced to deal with.
But another freshman who's learning the college game. Gibbs, boy, he was 4 feet behind the line, came up short. Tucker examines the floor. Koshwal is fouled, going to the bucket. 8th team foul on Pitt. Will shoot free throws after a timeout. Devin Hill trying to keep DePaul close. They trail by 19.
Our new island-inspired entrees are here for you at Red Lobster, like Caribbean rock lobster and shrimp, and citrus rum shrimp and scallops, both wood-fired grilled to sear in the natural juices. Ending soon at Red Lobster.
The Suzuki SX4 Sport has a unique pop-up Navi system, a roomy cabin, 30 miles per gallon highway, and more horsepower than the Honda Civic LX, all for under $16,000. So we can pretty much assure you'll have a great time in it. Once you're out of it, you're on your own. The Suzuki SX4. Live large, drive small. Suzuki. Now get 0% financing on all 2008 Suzuki Sport and Sedan models. Hurry in.
Our new island-inspired entrees are here for you at Red Lobster, like Caribbean rock lobster and shrimp, and citrus rum shrimp and scallops, both wood-fire grilled to sear in the net.
For everything electronic, say hello to OptimumStore.com. Exclusive deals on digital cameras, HD TVs, cordless phones, and more. And OptimumStore.com makes electronics easy with helpful tips and videos.
Like this beauty right here.
Check it out. Shop OptimumStore.com today, exclusively for Optimum customers.
Wake up. First thing?
Turn on News 12.
For me, it's the website.
I'm an on-demand kind of guy.
Local news, traffic, weather, then I'm out the door.
It's all at my fingertips.
News 12 to go? I can't live without it.
News12.com. I log on every day.
Love it.
I'm constantly connected.
24/7.
It's everything I want. I wish I could find a guy like that.
News 12 Long Island. Only on Cablevision, not on phone company TV or anywhere else.
The challenge continues Wednesday when the Devils battle the Islanders on MSG+.
Today's college basketball game has been brought to you by Virtual Wallet from PNC. Visit PNCVirtualWallet.com. And by the most critically acclaimed Volkswagen ever, the all-new CC. Beautiful day in Chicago. We are just outside of the great city. In Rosemont, Pitt leads DePaul 71-52. Today's Big East game being produced and distributed by ESPN Regional Television, Inc. Panthers 27-10 last year. They won the Big East tournament, lost to Michigan State in the second round of the NCAA tournament. Is this team as good as last year's?
They're better. I believe this team can go to the Final Four, and I'm not as impressed with North Carolina as a lot of other people, and they're not as healthy as they were at the start. But I never thought they defended as well as some people did. I think Pitt, if they get the right matchup, they stay healthy. I believe Jamie Dixon could have a ring on his finger with a national
title. Well, they haven't been to the Final Four partner since 1941, so you are stepping out.
Well, count me as a believer, because I had their game against Miami of Ohio back November 17, and I said to my partner at the time, Michael Regge, I guarantee you they start 16-0 minimum.
And they did. Last time a Pitt team advanced as far as the NCAA tournament's Elite Eight, they didn't even call it the Elite Eight. Bucket there. It was 1974.
Way back.
By the way, Blair scored again. That is 24 for the big fella.
He is just so impressive. I love the Pitt team. I really do. Of all the teams that I've seen or called games for this year, they're among my favorite teams to watch play, and I think they can win a national title. I really do.
Down low, Koshwal gets two. You know, Blair feels like you do. He has a picture in his room of Detroit's Ford Field, the site of the 2009 Final Four.
I would love to see, and maybe it'll happen, the leaders of the team, the Levants, Fields, the Youngs, the older guys, get everyone together and go, okay, guys, here's the deal. We got 60 days to be national champions. We're 60 days from the national title game. Let's have a meeting. No coaches, the players. 60-day sprint. Put everything else in your life other than your academics on hold. Focus. Nothing else matters. 60 days to win a title.
All right, here's their tournament resume. Only 3 wins against top 25 teams. Their strength of schedule, 9th. Losses both on the road to top 25 teams. They lost to Villanova and Louisville. And they're beating teams by 16 a game. That's second best in the Big East.
Yeah, they're going to have more wins against top 25 teams because they play in the best league in America in the Big East. I love how they defend. I like how hard they play. Even though they did have a slow start today, it's tough to get up and be ready to go at that razor-sharp margin every single day. But once you get down to conference tournament play and then selection Sunday, you better bring it every day.
Bazukas gets up on his own, gets back to the bench, and it's a tough 2 games to wrap up the regular season as we take a look at Michael Bazukas, the freshman from Munster, Indiana. Tough final 2 games for the Pitt Panthers. Home games against Marquette and UConn. Their next game will be against West Virginia, coming up on Monday. 9 points for Kenny Obi. It's career high. Paul trails by 16.
Paul's playing hard. They've really come with a great effort today.
Turnaround jumper, doesn't get the roll. Tucker looking for room. Right down the gut of the defense of Pitts and tapped in by Koshwal. Now
nice.
It's a 14-point game.
Nice job. They're hanging around. Just hanging around with 6 minutes to go. They are still in the ball game.
17 for Koshwal. If they can get it within 10, then you've got a bunch of young guys on the floor believing, hey, we're still in this game. Why can't we win it just like South Florida did last night against Marquette? Plenty of time left. Fields inside the line. Well, that'll bring you back to reality.
Real quick. Slaps you across the face and says, easy.
Don't get too excited.
Exactly.
11 for Fields. Back to the 16-point.
See, great teams, to win a title, you have to have, I believe, a senior floor leader or a veteran floor leader. We talked about Jermaine Dixon, his brother Juan, who was just an outstanding floor leader for Maryland. Offensive foul, no doubt about the call.
Sam Young called for the offensive foul, his 3rd.
Cannot swing the elbow, nearly drags the pivot foot and says, get off of me. Can't do it. And he knew it. Didn't say a word to the official. But you look back, think of the great Michigan State team Tom Izzo had, led by Mateen Cleaves, senior leader. You had Syracuse win. They had a great player in Carmelo Anthony, but Jerry McNamara, veteran floor guy. Juan Dixon at Maryland. It's just teams with great floor leaders can win. I think Pitt's got the whole package.
Well, he's got the luxury of having Fields. Tucker's 3-point attempt doesn't go. Young pulls down the miss. He's got Fields to run the offense, and then he's got a terrific score in Sam Young and just a rebounding machine who can also give you 15, 16 a game in DeJuan Blair.
And he's got depth.
Fields goes out of bounds. We'll stay with Pitt. 16 on the shot clock. We've talked about Dwan Blair and his 15th double-double. Sam Young also with a double-double, 10 points, 10 rebounds. Fields fends off the defender, and Blair just finishes.
Wow. He just knocked Fields to the ground.
His own teammate
his
to
own
get the head offensive rebound.
Popped. Wow.
Six offensive rebounds for Dwan Blair.
He's going to look at him and say, what are you doing? He's talking to him right now. There's the finish. Watch this. Here comes Fields inside. There's the flip. Does it go? And he just
stretches his 7'2" wingspan to just knock it back in.
Abuses his guy, and as he came over to the huddle, Fields, what are you doing to me?
77-59, Pitt in front. Golf fans and club pros, registration for the 2009 ESPN National Golf Challenge is already underway for courses and teams in the Gross Net and new 55 and older senior division. For more information, log on to ESPNGolf.com. There's a good shot of Dwan Blair, who grew up in a house just 600 yards from the Peterson Event Center where they play their home games at Pitt. There are his numbers today. 26 points, 11 of 18 from the floor, 11 rebounds, 6 on the offensive end. Tucker puts it on the floor. Working against Brown. Nice bounce pass. Jeremiah Kelly comes up short. Pitt's controlled this entire second half. Blair takes a couple of whacks at it, gets it. He can't be stopped.
Wow. He's looking at the crowd with a big smile saying, they can't handle me. Just turned to the crowd and said, they can't stop me. Watch this effort. Looking to bang the glass, keep it alive, and then they tackle him, and they can't stop him.
Boy, that is just brute strength. You can't stop me.
Yeah, not a chance. Sam Young over the top, foul number 4, I believe.
Again, he grew up just 600 yards from the Pitt campus, decided to stay home, signed with Pitt, became the first City League player to play for the Panthers in 16 years, only the third since Sam Clancy left campus back in 1981. He is just a terrific talent, and it's so good to see him stay home in the Hill District neighborhood. He's the Pied Piper, grown gargantuan, living in that area. Read a terrific article written by Dana O'Neill on ESPN.com. Just a great story about Dwan Blair growing up in the neighborhood and deciding, I'm going to stay home and turn around this program that I've been watching my whole life.
Right, why would you want to leave? Everyone that you know, care about, and love can come watch you play and go home when you want. Play in a phenomenal building and a great program. And he's one of the cornerstone guys.
Career high 28 in this game. Who does he remind you of in the NBA?
You know who he reminds me of as a player that I
look
at
him follow his shot.
Danny Fortson.
Who played, I was going to ask you if he reminds you of Max Seald, who played for Bob Huggins in Cincinnati.
There's another Cincinnati guy. Absolutely. But he reminds me a lot of Danny Fortson, who was a great player for the Bearcats and played in the NBA.
Devin Hill gets two. 81-62. Pitt up 19. Panthers with 20 wins, 8th consecutive season, 20 wins or more.
You know, Jamie Dixon is going to say, I guarantee you, that was a struggle. And people will say, you won by 19, 20, 22, whatever the margin of victory turns out to be. How was that a struggle? DePaul played very well in stretches here. Pitt did not come out with the normal energy level that you expect to see. And I'll tell you, Jamie Dixon had to really coach hard to get his guys turned around and right the ship.
Walker knocks down the two. This Pitt program really overlooked when you look at what they've accomplished. Past 7 years, their four Sweet 16 appearances, ranked behind only Kansas, Texas, and Duke. Those three squads with five appearances in the Sweet 16. They're the only Big East team to win 20 games overall, 10 in conference play, 8 years in running. Three-pointer falls
but
for
see,
Gilbert Brown.
What set that all up, he had a man on the baseline right near him. He gave him a good fake. The defense committed that way, started to go toward him, and then he kicked it to the corner for the open look.
15 assists for LeVance Fields. That's a career high. Devin Hill knocks down the turnaround jumper. He's got six. Blair at the other end.
My goodness. 32.
You said it best. My goodness.
We talked in the first half, said he's on his way to a career day. Didn't think he was going to be in the 30s.
Kajwal had it poked away. And he does things that don't even end up in the stat sheet.
No.
Timeout called by Jamie Dixon. Nope, we're going to keep going.
It's a timeout just so he can make some substitutions, get some guys in.
88-66, the Pitt Panthers putting on a clinic. Sam Young with a double-double in this game. Plenty of Pitt fans in the crowd here as well.
McGee wants the ball.
He gets it against Obi. Backing his way in. The right-handed hook goes.
Said, okay, the big fella, Blair, he's out of there. My turn. Get me the ball.
Will Walker, 5 feet behind the line, doesn't go. And now Dixon's out on the run. Throws it down with the left hand. Exclamation point. Jeremiah Kelly for three. They'll bring in some players just so guys can get a breather. 92-69. Pitt in front by 23. Last time these two teams played, last March, Pitt won 98-79. What a clinic by the Panthers today. Thanks to their big fellas. Juwan Blair did the job for Jamie Dixon today. Also Sam Young. 23-point advantage for the Panthers. Timeout on the floor. We'll wrap it up right after this.
I've never been all that great with my money, probably because I've never had much. But now that I'm making more, it's time to be a little smarter about how I manage it. With a calendar, I can schedule all my payments, and when funds are low, danger days help me stay out of the red. I can also transfer money with just a click and a drag. So maybe I'm better with money than I thought.
Introducing the virtual wallet from PNC, a high-definition online view of your money. PNC, leading the way.
College basketball fans, welcome to Hartford, home of the 2009 Big East Women's Basketball Championship, March 6th through 10th at the XL Center. Catch all 16 Big East teams live with packages just $99 for all sessions. Tickets are on sale now, so call 860-525-4500 or log on to Ticketmaster.com.
Millions of Americans have made Hydroxycut the number one weight loss supplement.
I'm Charlene from California, and I lost 55 pounds fast with Hydroxycut.
Subjects using the patented primary ingredients in Hydroxycut lost an average of up to 4.5 times the weight than diet and exercise alone. I strongly recommend it as a doctor and someone who used it with fantastic results.
I'm Stephanie from Wisconsin, and I lost 31 pounds so fast with Hydroxycut.
Get Hydroxycut, a new complete 7-day cleanse today.
Sunday, February 15th, MSG celebrates Black History Month with a groundbreaking lineup of originals and specials honoring the legends who have forever changed the face of sports. The great Jackie Robinson.
He was always a guy to stand up for his rights.
Super Bowl winning coach Tony Dungy. The Kings of the Ring, from Joe Louis to Muhammad Ali. And the man who broke the NBA color barrier, the Knicks' Sweetwater Clifton.
I really was the first one.
Celebrate Black History Month, Sunday, February 15th, starting at 6, only on MSG.
Pittsburgh leads DePaul 92-69. Sam Youngs, he's a poet, he's a writer, and he's got this written on his wall at home and up in his locker. He reads it before every game, just something to remind himself of who he is. Reads, I am strong body, mind, and spirit. I am different. I am cocky, confident, conceited, but humble. I am serious, but hilarious. Independent, but incomplete. I am special. I am a king in my own mind and have the wits of a god. I am the master of my fate and the captain of my soul. I am a believer, for believing is understanding life. I am a winner. I can't lose to any man, for when they come into contact with me, they have entered my world. I am impatient. I will leave anyone behind that doesn't want to help themselves. I am one of a kind. I am Sam Young. And Sam Young has had one heck of a game today.
And he is a stud. This guy can really play.
Young and Fields and Blair, their big three, put on a show today. Way too much for the young Blue Demons. 92-69, fifth-ranked Pitt beads DePaul. Dewan Blair with 32 points, 14 rebounds, 9 on the offensive end. LaVance Fields, 13 points, 16 assists. Sam Young had a double-double himself, 10 points, 10 rebounds. Matt Pajwal with 18. Dar Tucker had 18 as well. LaVance Fields, the distributor. As I said, a career-high 16 assists in this game. Came off a career-high 13 helpers against Robert Morris earlier in the week. And Dewan Blair, a man amongst boys. The top offensive rebounder in the country. Number 4 in the country when it comes to rebounds overall. Just under 13 a game. He had a monster effort as well. Pitt 92, DePaul 69. The Panthers now 21-2 on the season. 8-2 in league play. Now let's get it over to David Kaplan, who's standing alongside the winning head coach, Jamie Dixon.
Yes, coach, you guys started a little slow. You were very animated with your guys at a couple timeouts, and your defensive intensity turned the game.
Well, we got some turnovers, turned it into transition. I thought our offense was pretty good all the way through. LaVance just ran the show. 16 assists says a lot. So he's really rounding into form, you know. I mean, he's had a tough last 11 months, but he's getting to be where he was and even better.
How about Dewan Blair? 32 points, 14 boards, and unstoppable inside.
Well, we just kept getting the ball. The guy gets 16 assists. There's a reason why. And he's putting the ball. LaVance is delivering. We're spreading the floor. We're isolating him in the post, and he's finishing. But he has a knack for putting in, missing his own shot, and then putting it back in again. So he's always active on the boards, and he's playing, getting better and better.
This is a great basketball team. You've done an unbelievable job here. Do you talk with your guys at all about keeping your eye on a bigger prize, not just the conference, but this team could win a national championship?
Well, I think this team could be really good. I don't think we're there yet. I think we're getting better. You see, like, Jermaine Dixon and Bradley Wanamaker, those guys getting better. Gilbert needs to get play better. Terrell Biggs, we got to get him back. He was sick for a couple days. So, you know, the young guys are getting better, which is encouraging and gives us hope to get better as a team down the road.
Finally, how about the challenge of this conference? It's unbelievable night in and night out. DePaul came ready to play today.
Well, they did, and they have. I mean, I've watched all their games, and you can see they're close down the stretch. They seem to have gotten. They lose a close game to Cincinnati, a close game with Marquette at Marquette. I mean, they've been in close games. We know they have talented players. They've got some injuries, so their depth is hurting them right now. But, you know, they're going to beat somebody, and we've got them again, so I hope it's not us.
Coach, good luck. We'll see you in a couple weeks. All right, that is Jamie Dixon. Let's go back courtside to Luke Canell.
All right, nice job, David. Jamie Dixon, first coach in Pitt history to guide Pitt to 5 consecutive NCAA tournament appearances. 92-69, the final score, thanks in large part to these two guys. Dewan Blair, 32 points, 14 of 23 from the floor, 14 rebounds. LaVance Fields had 13 points, 6 of 12 from the floor, and 16 assists. With the victory, Pitt now 21-2. Coming up for the Panthers on their schedule, two home games, West Virginia and Cincinnati. Then they travel to top-ranked UConn. All three of those games on ESPN. Then they'll play host to this same DePaul team and then be on the road at Providence. For the Blue Demons, they'll play at home against Seton Hall. Then they go on the road at Louisville and Pitt. Two home games against Villanova and St. John's. Impressive Pitt is, aren't they?
Pitt can win a national title. Boy, are they talented. They've got the whole combination, and it starts with LaVance Fields, tremendous leader on the court.
DeJuan Blair with a picture in his room of Detroit's Ford Field, site of the 2009 NCAA Final Four. He was thinking Final Four today. Pitt beats DePaul in a romp, 92-69. For David Kaplan and our entire crew, this is Luke Kanellis. Sunday, be sure to tune in to more college basketball. The 7th-ranked Louisville travels to St. John's. Big East basketball on full court. For more information, log on to ESPNplus.com. The proceeding has been an exclusive presentation of ESPN Regional Television, the worldwide leader in collegiate sports. So long from Chicago.